I am sorry. It's time for cold, and we must make sure we eat inside the church because of our children. Immediately after the teaching, we will hunt the heater back, and we hope that the temperature in the church will still maintain it well. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Are you having a Bible in your hand?
Yes.
And I want you to please, if you have a pen and a paper, today being the first, last three Sunday, we declare what we call revival. It's for us to wake every one of us up. And for those who are not here today, maybe because of their distance, maybe some of them they fear cold, I cannot understand. But wherever they are, may God be with them in Jesus' name. Amen. Today is the first Sunday, as Amalia said, that we declare to pray unto the Lord. Today, we want to prophesy into our life. Today, we want to decree by the power of our Lord Jesus Christ into the new year. Why? We don't want to be the same again. We don't want to be stagnant. We want breakthrough. We want miracles. We want signs and wonder. We want our prayer to be answered. We want to move to the next level. We want good things of life. We want blessing. We want favor. We want good things of life. We want rest of mind. We want peace of mind. We want to be victorious. We don't want devil and demon and Satan to have power over us. We want whatever problem we have to be solved. Many of us have passed through many difficult times in 2019, and we want to put an end to it this year. We don't want sin to follow us to the new year.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Then it requires for every me and you to rise up to the occasion. Therefore, is a liar. It is not by mouth. You must confront devil and you must bring devil down. There is a saying that says, who fight and run away, we need to fight another one. When you are dealing with devil, it is not true. Because wherever you run to, devil will follow you there. You cannot run away from devil. There is no hiding place for you in the presence of devil. So you need to confront devil and you need to bring it down. May God bring devil down for us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus said, pray for your enemy. He's talking about enemy. He did not say you should pray for devil. Jesus did not say you should pray for demons. He's talking about human beings like you who offended you, you may bless them. If they don't like you, bless them. Pray for them. God should change their heart. God to change their mind. From evil to start doing good things. Yes, but when you are talking about demons, Satan, and devil, you need to confront him. You need to bring him down. May God bring devil down for us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The theme of our revival is called the Rock of Ages. Most of us, we say it by our mouth, but we don't actually know what we are saying. That is why I said, get a Bible in your hand, because after today's teaching, we are going to practicalize the word of God, and it will work miracle for us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
As I have said, a bottle of water has been presented, and you need a perfume, a soap, a white handkerchief, and candle. We will pray and we decree and we take it home and we begin to use it. I assure you, 2020, we are going to give testimony.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The theme of our revival is Rock of Ages. We all know what rock means. But we know what they call ages. In Yoruba, it's called Apatayeraye. What is it called in Benin or in Igbo? Translate it in your heart. What do we mean by rock? What do we mean by rock of ages? Children of God, can we go into the 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 4? Because I want to lay the foundation into the revival, the rock of ages, what it means. And how can we use the word of God as our prayer point? And when you are dealing with rock of ages, as woman, what should you do? Children of God, whoever see 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 4. If you don't have Bible in your hand now, then you are not a Christian.
And all drank the same spiritual drink.
All of us, we have the same spiritual drink. Yes?
For they drank of that spiritual rock that followed them.
They drank from the spiritual rock that followed them.
And the rock was Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The rock is what?
Christ.
Christ. The rock we are talking about, I will say the rock of ages. No wonder it's called the rock of. The rock is what?
Christ.
In the Bible, from Revelation, from the Genesis to Revelation, when they are talking about the rock, they are talking about our Lord Jesus Christ. He has been, the book of Revelation said, he has been before the world exists. That is why they call it the rock of ages. And after the world, he still exists. After there will be no world, he will still be exist. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He is the Alpha and the Omega. That is why the Bible says it's rock of ages. In the third, it is taken from book of Numbers. Because the third we tag the rock of ages is here. And it was taken from book of Numbers. Chapter 20, whoever see it, read it. Number 20, verse 8. What did he say?
Take the rock.
Yes?
And gather the assembly together.
Gather the assembly together as you are doing today.
Thou and my other brother.
Yes?
And speak ye unto the rock.
And do what? Speak unto the rock.
Before their eyes.
Before their eyes.
And shall give forth his water.
And he will give us water.
And that shall bring forth to them water out of the rock.
And the water shall come from the rock.
So that shall give the congregation and drink.
Hallelujah, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He said, gather people. As we are gathering today. And he's going to give us water of life. Amen. That nobody can give. And when he gives us the water of life, give it to all your people, because that water will come from the rock. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Remember in 1 Corinthians chapter 10, 4, it said, Jesus is the rock. That means whatever problem or situation we are going through, no pastor can do it for you. No prophet can do it for you. No bishop can do it for you. Bishop does not solve problems. Prophet does not solve problems. Pastor does not solve problems. They may pray unto the Lord the way you pray unto the Lord. And when God acting to their prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, it is done. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.